On it?
Yes.
Okay. So good evening, everyone. Welcome to this DTRS class of 127. And today, as all of you can see, we have selected our lead topic as the what is Paris Club. So basically, we have to understand what is this Paris Club and why it was in news. Okay. So now, before moving towards the questions, the MCQ, today we have something different for you. Generally, we are trying to give you quotation which is going to be useful for your ethics and the essay paper, and some which is useful for your motivational purposes also. But today I have given something different. Now, adopt CLIP method for unachieved goals. Adopt CLIP method for this unachieved goal. So what is basically this CLIP method? Now, generally what happens in our life is that we try to always live in our comfortable zone. We don't try to experiment with ourselves. And we generally have a tendency that in whatever area we are good, we will follow that area. We will live a comfortable life and we will not challenge ourselves. Now basically, and then when you come towards the UPSC preparation, and there are many, lots of challenges are there. Whether it is related to your schedule, whether it is related to your patience, whether it is related to your preparation, everything is there. So for that, from that perspective and in that context, I recommend a method known as the CLIP method. Now the very first thing CLIP stands for is that confront yourself. First thing is confront yourself. Whatever the limitations or whatever the comfort zone you have developed for yourself, confront with them. That is the first step. After confrontation, try to liberate yourself from those shackles jo bediyan apne kabiliyat mein dal rakha hai na, usse bahar nikal ke aana hai. To sabse pehle to usse confront karo, fir apne aap ko liberate karo ki ab मैं अपने आप को मुक्त कर दिया, यानी कि आई एम फ्री फ्रॉम ऑल दोज शैकल्स, फ्रॉम ऑल दोज लिमिटेशंस. देन व्हाट यू नीड टू, आई स्टैंड्स फॉर इज दैट इमर्स. जिस भी काम को आप फिर आप करना चाहते हो, फॉर एग्जांपल कोई भी एक सब्जेक्ट पढ़ना चाहते हो जो आप जिसमें आपका इंटरेस्ट नहीं था पर आप उसको करना चाहते हो, कोई एक हॉबी डेवलप करना चाहते हो, कुछ भी करना चाहते हो, तो उसमें इतना डूब जाओ, इमर्स हो जाओ. That is the third step. और फिर last में और उसको perform करो और उसके साथ में progress करो, ठीक है? और ये अपने lifelong अपनी इस ability को, इस idea को develop करो अपने अंदर में. So पहले confront, then liberate, then immerse yourself and then perform and get the progress. Okay? So that is what is this basically this और जो unachieved, जो नहीं किया हुआ है उसको आप इसके लिए फॉलो कर सकते हैं. ओके, नाउ कमिंग टू द नंबर ऑफ टॉपिक्स. सो टुडे वी हैव 10 टॉपिक्स एज ऑल ऑफ यू नो, स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम द पेरिस क्लब एंड गोइंग अप टू द कलबेलिया फोक डांस. ओके, सो वन बाय वन वी विल सी दैट व्हाट इज दिस. नाउ कंसीडर द फॉलोइंग कंट्रीज एंड इंस्टीट्यूशन व्हेन वी हैव द स्टेटस. ओके, हाउ मेनी ऑफ द अबव पेयर्स आर correctly matched with regard to the Paris Club membership. Now before this, all of you need to understand that what is basically this Paris Club membership. It is basically an informal group of creditors. Informal groups of creditors to lend to a particular country or any member country who is having some kind of debt issue. Okay, so basically it is related to that. Whenever any country is facing any kind of debt related issues and it is not able to repay debts, then these countries come together, an informal group, and they try to solve that problem. Okay, so again it is an international body, international institution, so you need to study about this. So what is the aim, what is the objective, what is the mission and vision, how its organization is there, where its headquarter is located, so all thing related to that. Now especially if you go towards the UPSC question, you would have find that many times they ask about the member countries, which are the member countries, what are their status. So based upon that, so here we have World Bank as the permanent member, Denmark as the ad hoc participant, and India as the observer. Now, if you study about this Paris Club, basically, the World Bank has an observer status, Denmark is a permanent member, and India has an ad hoc participant. So here the correct answer is option D. None of the pair are correctly matched. Okay. Now, what is the context of this? Basically, this question: Sri Lanka reaches agreement with India Paris Club on debt treatment. This is the context. Okay. So all this information is there. It is available in your file, that which are the permanent member country, what are their classification, ad hoc participant, observers. All these things are there. So we have given this. Okay. So now, again related to that same topic, there is a similar question in that context, because it was important, so it was necessary to cover it in detail. So we have covered it in two questions. Okay. Now consider the following statement regarding the extended fund facility. Extended fund facility. It is a funding mechanism under the ambit of the International Monetary Fund. Yes, extended fund facility is basically to help any member country to solve its balance of payment problem. Okay, if there is any problem in its balance of payment, then it is a funding mechanism under this IMF. So this is correct. Only the low income country facing a medium term balance of payment problem can access this fund in times of need. No, this is not a correct criteria. Even all member countries have this opportunity to avail this kind of extended fund facility. So this statement is incorrect. It does not mandate structural reforms within the borrowing economy. This is even also wrong. So if you are taking this kind of this extended fund facility, any particular economy, they have to introduce certain kind of structural changes within their economy. Okay. So this is related to your core economic subject also. How it is related? First of all, you study about what is balance of payment problem. What is balance of payment? What is the problem related to it? Now, what is this medium term balance of payment? There is small term, there is medium term, and there is large term. So what is that? What are the structural reforms? Whether India has suffered this or not, whether any kind of structural changes India has gone through or not. So basically important for your GS paper 3. Okay. And then there is one international institution, that is the IMF. Okay. So in that way, you have to study. As far as the answer is concerned, here answer is option A. Okay. So this is the similar context was there. So other related information are there. We have given, just read in the file, or you can visit even the website also. Okay. Now consider the following statement in the context of Legal Services Authority Act 1987. The income criteria to avail legal aid under this act is prescribed by the central government for cases before the Supreme Court and the High Court. And you can see that UPSC has similarly asked a question related to this National Legal Services, and related to that, in that context, we are asking about the Act of 1987, Legal Services Authorities. Okay. Now the income criteria. So basically the framework of this statement is that who all are eligible to receive this legal aid under this Legal Services Authority Act. And within that, there are many criteria are there. And in that criteria, one of the criteria is the income criteria. Now, what is that exact figure and who decides that? That is something all of you have to know. Now, as far as this high courts are concerned, if any case within this Legal Services Authority Act or this context is concerned, then the central government will decide the income criteria. Right now, 12,000 is the criteria which is given by the central government for cases before the Supreme Court. Okay, and it can change it also. Right now in the act, it is the 12,000. And if the case is before the High Court, then the respective state government will fix that. And as per that, 9K is the annual income. So if annual income is less than 9K, and up to 9K and up to 12, 9K, then for the High Court and for the central government before the Supreme Court, under it is 12K. So you can go, if your annual income, then you can, you know, fight or go after this Legal Services Authority Act. Okay, so remember this. So central government will not decide for the matter related to high courts. Remember this point. Okay, so this statement is incorrect. An affidavit made by a person as to his income may be regarded as sufficient for making him eligible to the entitlement of the legal services under this act. So this statement is correct, that basically self-certification has been given, but this is not an absolute statement. Remember that. This can be challenged, for example, if the concerned authority is not agreeing to the affidavit, or if he or that authority finds that there is some kind of wrong information is there, there is some kind of scrupulous activity is there, then he can, then that authority can reject also. But in the first go, the criteria, the affidavit is given to that individual person who is filing the application. So this is, statement is right, but it is not absolute right. That if he has, one has given the affidavit, then nothing can be questioned about the income criteria. It can be questioned by the authority itself. Okay, but within the context of the statement, this statement is right. So here the answer is option A. Okay, so study this. Now, so, and what was the context of the news? India hosts landmark regional conference on legal aid and technology. Okay, so that is the context of the question. Now, with reference to the United Nations, United National Liberation Front, United National Liberation Front, consider the following statement. It is the oldest valley-based insurgent group in Manipur. Yes, as far as this UNLF is concerned, it is a Métis group, okay, an insurgency group is there, which is there in the Manipur. It was formed with the demand of the secession from India under the leadership of Aribandham Samarendra Singh. This information is also correct. It is one of the seven Métis extremist organizations banned by the government of India under the National Security Act. All of you know that these kind of illegal organizations, they are banned under the UPA Act. Okay, UAPA, they are banned under the UAPA. So this statement is incorrect. So here the answer is option B. Okay, now let us see the context of the question. So history of UNMITI, basically how recently the central government has signed a peace deal with the this group. Okay, that is the context of this question. Now, with reference to Tejas aircraft, consider the following statement. It is the first fighter aircraft that has been indigenously developed in India. Now, if you remember the history of this, basically it is the HF-24 Marut, which was the first indigenous fighter aircraft which was developed by the HAL. Okay, so this is the Tejas is the second aircraft. So this statement is incorrect. It is a multi-role combat aircraft. Yes, multiple role it can perform, from air to air, air to air to water, air to all these kind of things are there. Surface to air is there. It can carry multiple warheads. So all these functions are there. So it is capable of a multi-role combat aircraft. The Tejas aircraft have been fully operationalized by inducting them into the flying squadron of the Indian Air Force. Yes, this statement is also correct. Right now, two squadrons are there which are functional. Okay, two functional since 2016. Two flying squadrons, operational squadrons are there with related to the or in the context of the Tejas aircraft. Remember that. Okay, so even this statement is also correct. So what do we find? Answer is option B. And first indigenous aircraft is the HF-24 Marut. Okay. Now, India to procure 97 Tejas jet. This is the context of the news. Okay. Consider the following statement about LEAD IT initiative. This initiative was jointly launched by India and Sweden. Yes, this statement is concerned correct. Basically, LEAD IT initiative is what? Basically, to achieve net zero carbon emission from the energy intensive industries. Okay, to achieve net zero emission from the energy in एनर्जी इंटेंसिव इंडस्ट्रीज. सो दैट वॉज एंड इट वॉज लॉन्च बेसिकली इन द UN क्लाइमेट समिट ऑफ द 2019. ओके, सो दिस स्टेटमेंट इज करेक्ट. The initiative aspires to attain a net zero carbon emission from energy intensive industry by 2070. No, this year is wrong. It is by the year of 2050. Okay? So it is not year 2070, it is the year of 2050. So this statement is incorrect. Answer is option A. Okay? Now, so this is the context of the news. Now, next question. With reference to the Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Ann Yojana scheme, consider the following statement. It is a food security welfare scheme operated by the Ministry of Consumer Affairs, Food and Public Distribution. Its nodal ministry is the Ministry of Finance. So basically, operational is the Ministry of Consumer and the administrative is the Ministry of Finance for this scheme. Okay, so both the statement are correct. Families belonging only to priority household category will be eligible for the scheme. Under the scheme, 10 kg of food grain per person per month is provided free of cost to all beneficiaries covered under the National Food Security Act. Now, if you want to, you may not be seeing that only priority household category will be eligible. And if you have studied ever this National Food Security Act, multiple groups are there. Okay, so this statement becomes incorrect. So all the categories who are part of the National Food Security Act will automatically be part of this. Okay, now under the scheme 10 kg of food grain, no, it is only the 5 kg of food grain is allowed. So this statement is incorrect. Both the statement, these two are incorrect, these two are correct. So answer is option B. Okay, so again, this scheme comes into news. So whatever the things are there, you or the schemes which are coming, you need to keep, it is useful that you revise it. Okay, only through revision you will be able to remember it for a longer time. Now, which of the following rivers flows through the Asola Bhati Wildlife Sanctuary? Yamuna River, Sahibi River, Luni River, none of the above. So here the correct answer is Sahibi River. Now you can, let us understand first of all the context. So basically we have seen that Delhi High Court has given a stay on a, some kind of event was proposed inside this sanctuary, but the Delhi High Court has given a stay on that, that it does not want to, that event should not happen. Basically whenever these kind of wildlife sanctuaries are there, so where they are located, their geographic location, which all states they cover, what are the hills, what are the rivers, what are the most important animal, if anything special or unique is there, you need to study and remember about all these things also. Okay, so as far as the answer is concerned, here the answer is option B. Okay, now it is the largest religious monument in the world. It was built by Khmer King Suryavarman II in the first half of the 12th century. It was originally dedicated to the Hindu god Vishnu before becoming a Buddhist temple by the end of the 12th century. In 1992, the temple complex was named a UNESCO World Heritage Site. So simply, it's a very easy answer. It should come to your mind that largest religious monument and it is related to Hindu god Vishnu, then it should be the Angkor Wat temple, okay, which is there in the Cambodia. So right now, let us first of all understand this context. You will come to know that Angkor Wat temple in Cambodia becomes 8th wonder of the world, defeats Italy Pompeii. Okay, so it is now classified as the 8 wonders. So what are all the wonders? You can do search for that also. Okay, so that is the answer. Now, with reference to the cultural history of India, consider the following statement about the Kalbelia folk dance. It is a community dance performed especially by women and is traditionally out of bound for men. The dance involves the use of the khanjari, percussion instrument, and pungi, the woodwind instrument traditionally played to capture snake. Now, as far as this Kalberia dance is concerned, it is related to the state of Rajasthan, and basically Jaisalmer is very famous for this folk dance. Now, it is a community dance, yes. Both men and women play a role in this. Okay? Both men and women play a role in this. So, this statement is incorrect. Basically, women dances and it is the men who are playing this khanjari and this pungi instrument. Okay? So, second statement is correct. It involves the use of the khanjari and the pungi woodwind instrument. So, what do we find? Here, the correct answer is option B. Now, how you can prepare this is that there is a Kalbelia folk dance. So you take the state of Rajasthan, and then whatever are its cultural, whether it is related to visual art, whether it is related to performing arts, you study about it. In that way, state wise, you can cover your art and culture portion also. That is one of the way. So Kalbelia, the folk dance is there. So all what is related to the state of Rajasthan, you can prepare and you can revise it. Okay. So the answer is option B. So now what is the context? Basically, international festival was there. We have seen that Rajasthan International Folk Festival was there and Kalbelia dance was performed there. Okay. So that's all for today's MCQ, for today's DTRS. Keep revising the things and keep reading the things. Okay. Thank you.